Hi everyone. I hope in my previous lectures we have seen about our variables, identifier, keyword, data types, and how the structure of C program would be, history of C program, all those stuffs. So today I will explain you, or I will just touch upon how to write a basic program in the compiler. So in this video we'll see how to write the basic program. In the upcoming videos, I will execute the same program in the compiler. So you know that the structure of C program, the very first line will be about the comment line, but the comment line is optional. But here I am giving the comment line slash asterisk. So program to print hello world. I have just take the very simple example, and I have give star and slash. So this is the comment line. I have written a code hash include, okay, hash include stdio dot h. I will briefly explain what is include hash symbol and then greater than less than. So this is used to indicate the header file. And next one, I have just simply used directly int main. So there are two types of main. One is a void main. It does not return any value. Int main, it is going to return integer value. So here I have just used only the output statement printf. Whatever we are giving it in a double quotes, let us give the double quotes as hello world. Bracket. And then close semicolon. Semicolon indicates the end of the line. And then since I am using int main, I've just used return zero. And then close parenthesis. So the execution starts from here to here. This is the basic way to write the program. So the output of the following program, obviously hello world. Obviously hello world. Maybe in my upcoming video, how to give a printf statement. As of now, just understand that whatever given in the double quotes, it will be printed. The same thing, I have just asked, add a two number. So the same program, I have just used hash include, okay, hash include stdio dot h. Okay, hash include stdio dot h. And then here I am using int main. I need two variables because I am going to add two number. So I have just used a data type called integer, a equal to 5 and b equal to 6. So two integer, comma is used to separate the variable. A is a one variable, the value of a is 5. And B is an another variable, the value of B is 6. And by using printf statement, I hope during my data types I have discussed. So this is the access specifier or format specifier, percentage D, comma, I am just giving here A plus B, close braces, semicolon. And as usual, return 0 and close braces. So this is going to return integer value. Why you are giving one more return zero? Return zero, what I am saying, the entire main function. Sometimes you are giving int main, you are asking you to print some other value. So that time the compiler will not recognize. So just take this as if you are using int main, here you have to give a return zero. Return zero means the value zero is an integer. It is returning that value and it will exit the program. But here the concept is this one, A plus B. Don't put this circle here, actually comma. Okay. So the thing is A plus B, if you are add 5 plus 6, obviously 11. 11 is an integer. That's why I'm giving percentage D. So instead of that percentage D, if I am giving percentage S and if I am giving A plus B, the output might be 5.0 because the output will be treated as a float. Whereas integer is a smaller byte and float is a higher byte. So don't say that's a long int is a 4 byte. Okay, unsigned long int, signed long int. Don't treat like that. So integer is the smallest data type and float is the normal compared to integer, it is the highest one because it occupies 4 bytes, it is occupies 2 bytes, but long int we can say it is a 4 byte. So you can like, even though if you are declaring 5 and 6, but if you are adding two numbers, the output might be as a percentage F or percentage D. The higher order is applicable. So integer, you can print the value as float. So that's why 5.0. Now the question is, should I give A plus B, or else you can give int C equal to A plus B semicolon, and you can give that C value here. So what is the meaning of this is, I am adding two number, the result value will be stored in C. Clear? I hope you will understand this. So here I am just passing the input and then I am printing that output. But we have one more statement. That statement is called a scanf. So scanf is used to pass the input, specifically runtime input. Okay. So it is used to pass the input. So here I am just going to pass the input. So for that, I have just erased it. And then I am using the, I'll just explain you how to pass the input by using a scanf statement. So basically, this is the very, very, very what to say, like a beginning level of C programming. If you follow my YouTube channel, you will understand that how this will be get into not only the beginners, all those things, like you can increase the size and you can erase it clearly. Okay, so all those complex programs also we are going to slowly include that. So our aim is to make you fundamentally very strong. So what I said, how can I use it? By using the scanf statement. So same thing, hash include, okay, hash include stdio.h void main. Void main means you don't want to use return zero. And here I'm declaring three variable int A, B, C. Fine, no issues. Now, by using scanf statement, so here I have to again percentage D, percentage, sir, why two percentage? One is for A, another one is for B, and double quotes, and then comma, definitely you have to give address symbol A and address of symbol B. So why you are giving address? Because in that memory location, the value will be stored. Okay, in that memory location, the value will be stored. And after that, you can use C equal to A plus B. And then you can print the value, print F percentage D comma C. The basic difference between scanf and printf is, printf, you are not going to give ampersand symbol. You are just directly display the value. But here you are going to store the value. Store the value means we need an address. That's why you are using this as an ampersand symbol. This is as an address of operator. This is also called as what? Address of operator. So it's a very important thing. Here in this program, I'm not passing input. I can give the input through runtime by using a scanf statement. Okay. So I hope you will understand my video. If you understand my video, please click the like button and you can share it with your friends. Leave the comment, whatever topic I want to make a video, and don't forget to click the bell button. So it will help you to receive the future videos. Thank you.